flowing over both the surface of the plate having unit meter length.
Yes, sir, that one, it's done.
It's done now.
Yes, sir, that was the first problem we did.
No, similar type, one more. Actually, I have given four problem, no?
Yes, sir, from that one is all.
Wait, I'll check. No, the first problem what we did is air at 30 degrees centigrade, no? First problem what we did is air at 30 degrees.
The problem air at 30 degrees
centigrade. Yeah, that we did.
No, so that's second problem.
No, I'll read out this problem.
So that is second problem. We have done two questions.
Yeah, two questions you've done, no?
Sir, here at 30 degrees is the third problem.
Okay. You have done three. You take this problem. This is also one of the problem where I have not done this. Air at 25 is flowing over both the surface of the plate, having unit to meter length.
You have completed that, sir. It's completed. That's
now. What is the power developed in that?
Power developed.
Power required to overcome the drag force. We are not done, no?
That one question we haven't done, sir. That total power required to overcome the drag force. Except that all is
completed. That's what I had. Except the total power, everything is done, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Sorry. That you add up the total power required to overcome the drag force. Total power required to overcome the drag force.
Okay, sir.
Okay. First, I'll complete that. Only that one, that problem, that total power required, I'll explain. So, what is the formula for power? As you know, basic formula for power. What is the unit for the power? It is watts. So, this is force into velocity. What is it? So, how I got this formula? If you don't know the formula for power, you go with dimensional analysis. So, force into u velocity, will get a W. What is the force? Drag force we got? Drag force. 0 into u velocity is 5. So, therefore, power required to overcome the drag force is 0.171 watts. Okay.
So,
0.171. Huh?
We can't see the screen, sir.
Just a minute.
Yes, sir. Now it's fine.
The power formula is F into U, that is velocity. F we know 0.0342 and velocity is 5. Correct? No, answer is force. Answer is same. Therefore, total power required to overcome the drag force is that much. Okay, now we'll go for one more. We'll go for one more problem, which is that the one more problem I'll proceed. Next problem, that is air with a velocity of 3 meters per second and 20 degree centigrade flows over a flat plate along its length L into B into T of plate 150 into 2 centimeter. The top surface of the plate is 80 degrees centigrade. Find the Q. Temperature of the plate at the bottom surfaces, assuming K of the plate as 23. So here, almost the procedure is same as the previous problem, except this one. Find out the temperature of the plate at the bottom surface. That is the only change in this. So first, I'll write down the data. Just I'll write the formulas. You find out the answer and keep it with you. Okay? Up to till Q, I'll not explain. After Q, I'll explain. That is to find out the temperature of the plate at the bottom surface. See, now assume that there is a plate. Okay, there is a plate having some thickness. Till now, he was not given any thickness of the plate. Now, the thickness of the plate is 2 centimeter, 2 into 10 to the power of 2 meters. and this is called length of the plate. Length of the plate is 100 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters, and width is 50. So that I take that as B, W or B is equal to 50 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. That is the width of the plate. Next, what he has given, above this plate, air is flowing with a velocity of, that is U. U infinity is the velocity of the air, 5 meters per second. This is 3 meter per second, which is flowing at the temperature of 20 degrees centigrade. And the flat plate along with the length and width I have taken. The top surface of the plate, that is T wall, is equal to 80 degrees centigrade. T wall is 80 degrees centigrade. He is asking you to find out the Q. He is asking you to find out the temperature. So this is a new thing. We are not done till now. Temperature at bottom of plate. I'll explain only this part in this problem. Assuming thermal conductivity of the plate as 23 watts per meter Kelvin. So this is the data given. So air is flowing. If the air is flowing above the surface at a velocity of something and having a temperature, so what is the first step? Can you tell? First step, you take TF, that is film temperature, T wall plus T air divided by 2. You will get the film temperature. Then properties of air at TF. So what are all the properties you take? You take rho, mu, PR, K. Those are all the properties you will take from the data. That you already done. You know how to take that. So I will not repeat that concept. Then after that, third step, we'll find out Nusselt number. What is the Nusselt? Before this Nusselt number, we'll go with Reynolds number. No? Reynolds number. What is Reynolds number? Rho V L. Instead of V, we can put it as U. V is nothing but velocity. Now U is the velocity for us, U infinity by mu. Rho is given. Rho is from the data handbook. U is given. Length of the plate is given. Only mu is also given. Find out Reynolds number. Based on this, you'll write a note. What is this? Whether the flow is laminar or turbulent. Definitely, I know that this problem is coming across the laminar flow because the length of the plate is small. This laminar is here, a transition is occurring here. Where the laminar flow is, the plate length is smaller compared to the laminar flow length. So, no worry. It will come in the laminar flow only. So, if it is laminar, we will go with the Nusselt number. What is the Nusselt number? 0.332 Reynolds number to the power of 0.5, Prandtl number to the power of 0.333. This is the formula we use, and we go, we'll get a Nusselt number, 10. Again, Nusselt number is equal to what? H, L by K. Nusselt number is known, K is known, L is known. From here, you take out H. Then, to substitute in Q, we don't want H, we want H average. To get H average, what is for a laminar flow? H average is equal to 2 into H. For a laminar flow, that is. If it is turbulent flow, H average is equal to 1 by 0.8 into H. That is the only difference between laminar and turbulent flow. Then, 8th step. What is the 8th step? Q is equal to H average into area into T wall minus T infinity. So H average we got from this. Area is length into width. TW is known. T infinity is known. So from that equation, we will get the Q. The first unknown is easily obtained. Correct. Any doubts in the first unknown? Till the first unknown? Any doubts in this procedure? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay. See, procedure is same for all the problems. Only here and there, small changes he will ask. If it is turbulent flow, what should be done? This is fixed. This is fixed. This is fixed. Note is also fixed. Any type of flow, either it will be laminar, turbulent, anything. If it is turbulent, then the formula of nu will be changed. That's all. After this, this formula remains same as it is, and this will change if it is turbulent. 1 by 0.8 into h. That's all for laminar and turbulent. If he is asking to find out the length of critical, what is the length of the plate at which the laminar is converting into turbulent, then you take Rea is equal to 10 into 5 into 10 to the power of 5. Find out L. Don't use the L whatever he has given. He is asking you to find out where the laminar is converting into turbulent. Then Re is equal to 10 to the power of 5 into 10 to the power of 5. Substitute and find the value of L. That's all. See, the procedure is same for all the problems except the last unknowns. In the previous problem, as I thought, there was only power, means power required to overcome the drag force. The formula was not there. I told you to write down the formula. Like that, before the class, I explained about the force. What is the drag force? Drag force, because there is no formula. So all those things are basics. You should know from the basic force again. What is the formula? What is the formula for tau? Everything. And what is the formula for power, force? And okay, till here it is completed. Now I'll go with the one more unknown, which is not done till here. What is not done till here? If the rate of heat transfer from the plate and the air is taking place, something as, say for example, I got Q as 204.4 watts. This is the Q I got, 204.4 watts. If I solve the problem, if you go for the problem solution, you'll get the Q as 204.4. Clear? Done. What he is asking now, can you tell? This temperature of the wall is only at the top. This is 80 degrees centigrade. What is the temperature of the plate here at the bottom? If the rate of heat transfer is 204.4, what is the temperature at this location? How will fall? How to solve this problem, can you tell? There is one plate, top surface it is 80 degree, and the Q you know, and the length of the plate is, means this thickness of the plate is known, thermal conductivity of the plate is known. How to identify or how to solve the problem to get the temperature at the bottom surface, whether it will be greater or lesser than the 80 degree centigrade? Can anybody tell? This is related to find the temperature at the bottom surface of the plate is related to the first module. That is related to the first module. We know one surface temperature, other surface temperature is unknown, but the thickness of the plate is known, thermal conductivity of the plate is known. So what is the formula? Can anybody tell? From the first
Q is equal to delta T by R.
Q is equal to, yeah, very good. Delta T by R. Excellent. Delta T by R. So delta T is 80 minus of unknown by, what is R? L by K into G. Correct. But here, you get confused. What is this L to be substituted and what is the L I have substituted? See, 80 minus how much divided by, this is nothing but thickness divided by K into E. So why I converted the L into thickness?
So length is thickness, sir.
Yes, yes. Here, in this chapter, length I consider in this where the air is flowing. But in the first module, we consider the thickness of the material as the length of A, length of B, length of C. So this is the thickness of the material. Means the same arrangement we kept vertical and we explained. Correct? So that's what we have taken as T. So I'll write the values. 80 minus how much divided by T is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 2. That is thickness of the material divided by K. Thermal conductivity is 23. And area. What is the area? Area is?
Length into width.
Yes. 50 into 100. So 100 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Into 50 into 10 to the power of minus 2. See, this is the only confusing thing in the heat transfer subject. In this first chapter, we are taking this itself as L, but here we are taking that as T. You should know the figure and you should understand why we are converting that, we are rewriting this L as T. Many students, what they will do, they will know this formula. Delta T by R, they will be knowing. Delta T what to do, R what to do, they will be knowing. But L, by mistake, they will take 100 meters. Understood? That is the mistake what the students will do. So I told in this subject, you should know and you should be thorough with the configurations. If I place the configuration by some other way, what is L, what is P, that you should know. If anybody having doubt, please ask me. Find out the temperature of the plate below this. So because of this solid material, there is some resistance. There will be temperature drop. What is the temperature drop? You please tell me. You please tell the drop in temperature. That is temperature of the plate at bottom surface. Temperature of plate at bottom. How much it is? It should be definitely less than 80. Whether it should be less than 80 degree or greater than 80 degree. Can you tell? Okay, check out and tell the answer as per. All the values of this one you calculate. QI is 204.4. You substitute here, find out the temperature of the plate at the bottom. I'll tell you what is the answer how you got. So, means, if you got the answer, what is the reason you are getting that answer? I'll tell you. Can I tell what is the answer you got?
Sir, wait, sir.
Temperature of the plate at bottom. See, anybody having doubt, please ask me to stop. I'll explain. Shall I write answer?
Wait, sir.
Sir, the answer is 79.6.
No, check out.
We got that, sir.
76.45.
Temperature of the bottom is 100.35. Please check out. Q is 204.4. I hope you'll get negative answer. Check out the answer.
So 79.64.
Everybody got the same answer. Once again, I got 100. Okay, I'll check out. Today morning only I calculated and check up it. Two not 4.4 into 3 into
The thickness is negligible.
We'll see. Wait. I don't know. Okay, you tell me the answer. I think probably I done mistake. You tell me the answer.
79.64
degree centigrade. Okay, that is the temperature of the plate at the bottom surface. Okay. Just I'll rewrite. Here I got something answer. Just I'll overwrite. Wait. Okay, fine. We'll go for the next problem. Which is the next one? Which I have not done, which I have sent the question?
To the engine oil.
Very good. We'll go for the engine oil. Till now, all the problem we did with air. Now, I will go with the other fluids. See, whatever may be the fluid he is using, procedure is same. But the formulas will be different. Nu for the air, it is different. Nu, if it is fluid, it is different. I'll show you what it is. What are the difference? Please, all of you open the data handbook. Meanwhile, first I'll read the datas. Then I'll show you the data handbook. Okay. What is given? An engine oil. What is the fluid now? Fluid is engine oil. Fluid is engine oil, which is under 25 degrees centigrade. That means T infinity is 25 degrees centigrade. Instead of here, he has taken engine oil. He is supplied over a plate of 30 into 20 centimeter. Just we know 30 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 centimeters. So this is area we know. But what is length in that? See, length is 1, width is 1. I don't know whether this is length or this is length. Further, we'll read the problem. What is given? The engine oil is flowing with a velocity of, that is u infinity, is given 1.5 meters per second. Flow is parallel to 30 centimeter side. That means what? The engine oil is flowing parallel to 30 meter side. That means I know that length is, with that sentence I came to know, length is this, width is this. Understood? See, by this sentence, I don't know which is length and which is width. The plate may be like this, no? The plate may be like this. That means here 30, 20 here and 30 here. Or the plate may be like this also. This is also okay. This is 20 and this is 30. Both in this, if I observe this area, here also area same, here also area same. But the velocity here, which is flowing, the effect will be different here, effect will be different here, correct? Because of the orientation. So in the next sentence, he has given the velocity of the flow is parallel to 30 mm sides. That means the air which is now fluid, which is flowing, is parallel to 30 mm. So this is L and this is width. Understood? There are some problems where width is bigger compared to length. That is also there. I'll solve further classes. Now all the problems we did in such a way that length is bigger, width is small. This is also in this type of case also there, where the width is bigger, length is very, very small. This problem also will solve. That means, see this. This is a plate, correct? Assume that this is a plate. I am keeping a plate here. If the engine oil is flowing over the surface, parallel to 30 mm side. Where is this? Is 30 mm and this is 20 mm. There are some problems where the engine oil is flowing towards the 20 mm side. That is also there. We will solve in the next class or after this problem. So here, after this, what is given? The temperature of the plate, that is T wall, is 55 degrees centigrade. He is asking one simple thing, that is to find out Q. So to find out Q, the procedure is same. Procedure is same. First thing, you find out T. Sorry, I'll write at the top. I'll write to the top. T film. You draw the figure. You must draw the figure for all the problems. T film is equal to T wall plus T infinity by 2. So T wall is 55. T infinity is 25. 55 plus 25 by 2. That is 40 degrees centigrade. You find out, second step is property of engine oil at 40 degrees centigrade. Don't see the property of air. I know by mistake, if you find the property of air, the solution goes wrong. First, you should write down what is the fluid given. Now the fluid given is engine oil. With that engine oil, you might take, you try to solve. The property of engine oil is 40 degrees centigrade. At 40 degrees centigrade, can you be able to see from that handbook? Can you able to check from that handbook or whether it should project? Somebody reply. Hello. Okay. I'll project it. Just a minute, I'm projecting the handbook. Can you see the reference book? Yeah, here there is a, if there is a water given, water is flowing above the surface. You use this table and take the property. If the ammonia is flowing over the surface, use this table, this ammonia values, and take the values, properties. Like that, if it is carbon dioxide, if it is glycerin, like the different oils, whatever the oil is given, you concentrate and take the values. Now he has given engine oil here. Engine oil unused. It is in the page number 24. Page number 24. Definitely there is a properties at 40 degrees centigrade. It is marked there. Temperature at 40 degrees centigrade. What are all the properties? If the given problem, if you get T film as 50 degree, then what you will do? Engine oil, if TF is 50 degree, then interpolate and take the values. Now, because of just to save the time, I'm not using the problem of interpolating. Directly, I'll give the values which is there in the data handbook. If not, you interpolate. I hope you know how to interpolate. Here also, you take the same property, that is rho mu k pr. So these are all the properties you're supposed to take. So what is the rho at 40 degrees centigrade for engine oil? Rho is 4876 kg per meter cube. Mu 241 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Frontal number 2870. Thermal conductivity 0.1442. See, this is very, very important stuff. Students will go here only the mistake. why in general they will try to solve the problem correctly, but the properties they used to take for air. No, it's supposed to be taken for engine oil. Next, after taking the property, go back for the sheet of convection chapter, that is 112, page number. Go for page number 112. Okay. Now still we are in the problem called flat plate. We are solving the problems on flat plate. Okay. So after this, what is the next step I supposed to do? I supposed to find out the Reynolds number. So we'll find out Reynolds number. Reynolds number is equal to rho V R. Whether he is given to find out the Reynolds number at certain length, he has not given anything. Just he is asking Q. So that means Q for the overall plate. Then rho V L by mu. Length is the overall length of the plate. So rho is known, 876. Velocity is 1.5. V is nothing but u infinity. L is nothing but length of the plate, 30 into 10 to the power of minus 2 divided by mu, 241 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Re, we will get a very huge value, that is 1635684.6, which is greater than, much greater than 5 into 10 to the power of 5. Hence, flow is turbulent. Hence, the flow is turbulent. Clear? Can you see the board? I have written Reynolds number, I found out the value, and I have also found out, hence the rho is huge, the flow is turbulent. Can you find out?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, after this, what is the procedure? We used to go for Nusselt number, correct? So there is small change in the Nusselt number. Nusselt number for turbulent flow. Nusselt number for the turbulent flow. What is the Nusselt number for the turbulent flow? And that too, not for the air. In the previous problem, we did something else. Nusselt number for the turbulent flow for the air. There is something. But here you check out equation number 1.1.2. Can you see there? For liquid metals, low Prandtl number, and for what is that? Silicons, high Prandtl numbers. See, what is the Prandtl number in this equation, in this problem? The Prandtl number is around 2870. That is the value of Prandtl number. But in the previous problem, whenever there is air, the Prandtl number will be in the form of 0.697. But now, as it is a liquid, the Prandtl number is very huge. So you supposed to use the Prandtl number, the Nusselt number equation from equation number 1.1.2. So what is the equation for equation number 1.1.2? 0.3387 Reynolds number to the power of 0.5, Prandtl number to the power of 0.333 whole divided by 1 plus 0.0468 by Prandtl number, this to the power of 0.67 whole to the power of 0.25. So I'll close this data handbook. I'll stop sharing, because once you know that equation, that is not required. Data handbook is not required for me. See, now you know Nusselt number for laminar flow. You know Nusselt number for turbulent flow if it is air. But if it is liquid, if the liquid is flowing around the surface and the flow is turbulent, then use this equation. Don't forget, this is very, very important step. Why I taken this Nusselt number even the flow is turbulent? In the last problem also we got turbulent flow, but we have taken something else. Why? Because the fluid is air, but here the fluid is oil and the Prandtl number is very, very high. Because of that, we are supposed to take this equation. So, if you substitute everything there, if you substitute all the values in this, the value of Nusselt number, we will get as 6138.6 is the Nusselt number, like what I got. 613.86 is the Nusselt number, what I got for this engine oil whenever it is turbulent. Why only student strength is less today? Only 28. Okay. Once you finish the Nusselt number, I hope you have done this. I'll go for the next step, that is finding the value of H. Once you finish the Nusselt number, you go for the value of H. What is the value of H? Nusselt number is equal to HL by K. So take out H from this. All the values are known. Nusselt number we got just now. You take H value from it. So the value of H is 2950.6. See, don't believe whatever I'm writing, it is correct. You check out with the calci. You do the calculation work and find out. Once you found H, this is not required. H is not required to substitute in Q. H average. So that H average is equal to, hence it is turbulent flow, 1 by 0.8 inch H. This is because of turbulent flow. If it is laminar, 2 inter H. If it is laminar, this will also change. So we'll get H average as 3688.25. So once you get H average, substitute in Q. Q is equal to H average area T wall minus T infinity. This formula remains same. H average you got now. Area is given 20 in the 30 in the power of minus 2. T wall, T infinity. You will get Q. Q as 6638.8 watts. So this is a Q. So any doubt, please ask me. With respect to other fluids, if it is not air, how to do? If it is air, under laminar, I explained. Under turbulent, I have finished. If it is oil, under turbulent, how to do? I have explained. You please ask me if I am having any doubt. I'll come with few more problems.
Sir, here the whole plate, it is turbulent flow only, sir.
Whole plate is turbulent flow only because wait. What he is asking? Oh, correct. So like, good question you asked. Wait, just I'll check out. He is asking something. What is that? See here. I'll show you the figure. Very good. Very good question what you asked. This is the plate, and hence the fluid is, hence the some engine oil is using, and the Prandtl number is very high in this case. The laminar flow is very, very small, and length of the laminar flow is not at all considered. Everywhere at the beginning only, the flow occurs into the form of turbulent region only. From the beginning only, the flow is the turbulent. From the beginning only, the flow is a turbulent region. There is no laminar region in this problem. Why sir, there is no laminar region? Yes.
If laminar region is there, how will we know, sir? Like, how to calculate, sir?
You have to use the Reynolds number is equal to 5 into 10 to the power of 5. Critical Reynolds number.
So there will be no case that both are there, sir, laminar and turbulent.
In all the cases, laminar and turbulent flow will be existing. So in all the cases, laminar and turbulent flow will be existing. Just I'll wrap this and I'll show you for this problem what will happen. For this problem, this is a solution. That the solution is completed. Now I'll show you if it is laminar flow, what is the length? See here. We will take the length. So we'll take Reynolds number critical as 5 into 10 to the power of 5 is equal to rho v L by mu. In this case, you find out L. We'll see. The length of the plate now it is 30 into 10 to the power of minus 2. This is total length of the plate. So this length is only effective length for Reynolds number, means Reynolds number or the laminar flow. You check out what is the length of this. So what is the rho we got? 876 into velocity is 1.5 into divided by mu, 241. So can you check the value here? How much you got?
So 0.09 meter.
8, 7, 2, 6, 5. See here, 0.091 meters. Understood here? What is the meaning? Why I taken the entire length as turbulent flow? The reason behind that is the value of length is not even 1 millimeter. It is not even 0.1 millimeter. It is 0.091. So that the laminar flow region is very, very small. And from here only the turbulent region occurs. So this is called the length of the laminar flow, and that is called length of the turbulent flow. And hence it is very, very small. Just we are neglecting it, and we are taking that entire length itself as the turbulent flow.
Sir, if it is not negligible, we should consider both, sir.
Yes, if it is not negligible, we are supposed to consider both. That means that how you'll come to know if it is not negligible, whether it is negligible or not, that will come to know only with the help of Reynolds number. Earlier we did Reynolds number. What is the Reynolds number we got? We got 16 into 10 to the power of 5, correct?
Yes, sir.
But here the critical is only 5 into 10 to the power of 5. See the difference. 16 is too far from the 5 compared to 5 into 10 to the power of 5 into 16 into 10 to the power of 5. Clear?
Yes,
so
sir.
We can understand that this value is very small. Laminar flow region is small compared to turbulent. If for this problem only, if the Reynolds number we got 6 into 10 to the power of 5 or 5.5 into 10 to the power of 5, then definitely you check out this laminar region will be up to certain length. Up to certain length there will be a laminar region, then there will be turbulent. So in that case, you're supposed to solve Q by laminar region, Q by turbulent region, add up those two to find out the Q. Clear?
Yes, sir.
That depends upon the Reynolds number. The critical Reynolds number, if you know, then we will come to know whether I should use laminar and turbulent both or just turbulent. That is the reason.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, fine. A good question. Good observation. Actually, I didn't thought that to explain that because any of it is very, very small. Good observation. So I'll go for the next problem. See, all the problems, whatever I given, it is finished, no? All the four problems, it is done in the class, no? Hello?
Yes, sir, it's done.
Okay, fine then. Then we'll go for the next problem.
So for the Q formula, sir, we should use H average or H X, sir, for laminar.
Average
and,
for always if he is asking capital Q, that is total Q, we are supposed to use average X. Average X for the total Q. In some cases, he will ask find out the Q at particular location. Then you use HX.
Okay, sir. So both for laminar and turbulent, sir.
Yeah, both for laminar and turbulent. You say that he will ask in the question clearly. Find out the local heat transfer. Local heat transfer means you supposed to use HX. If he asks you to just to find out heat transfer, then convert everything into average, then find out the Q.
Okay.
If you ask capital Q, he will ask average only. He will not ask local. But if you ask small Q, then he will ask at local.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So we'll go for one more problem. I think all the problems given are completed, no? All the given problems are completed, I guess. See, for the same problem, if you ask to find out CFX, average CFX, thickness of the boundary layer, thickness of the thermal boundary layer, can you find out? For the same problem, if I ask thickness of the boundary layer, thickness of the thermal boundary layer at length L. So all those things are direct formula, substitute and get the value. You can do that. So hoping that you can do, I'll proceed further. Now we'll come across keeping the plate horizontally. What is the effect? Keeping the plate means if the air is blowing like this, if I keep the longer distance along with the air or the shorter distance along with the air movement, what will happen? What is the effect? We'll check out. Take this problem. Air at atmospheric pressure and 20 degree centigrade flows over air at atmospheric pressure and 20 degree centigrade flows over a flat plate. Flows over a flat plate at 180 meters per minute. 180 meters per minute. You are supposed to convert into meter per second. He has given 180 meter per minute. Full stop. The plate is 50 into 25 centimeter. The plate is 50 into 25 centimeter. Find out the heat loss. Find out the heat loss. Find out the heat loss. If the plate is parallel, if the plate is parallel to, parallel to, sorry, if the flow is parallel to, if the flow is parallel to 50 centimeter sides of the plate, if the flow is parallel to 50 centimeter sides of the plate, and if the flow is parallel to, and if the flow is parallel to 25 centimeters side, 25 centimeter side, what will be the, what will be the effect on heat transfer? What will be the effect on heat transfer? What will be the effect on heat transfer? Question mark. Also find, also find, also find the increase in heat transfer by the arrangement. Also find the increase in the heat transfer by the arrangement. Also find the increase in heat transfer by the arrangement. And percentage increase in the heat transfer. 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 Can you try this? Can you try this by yourself?
Yes, sir.
So what he has given, this problem what I given, first thing you should observe is what is the fluid. The fluid is air, so that you're supposed to take the properties of air. Then whether the plate is kept, what is the length, means the length is nothing but parallel to the flow of the air. Once in the first case he has given the length is 50 centimeter, and other case the length is 25 centimeter. Procedure is same. So keep, just by changing the length, you will be having different values of Reynolds number, different values of Nusselt number, H average, and Q. Everything will be changed just by interchanging the position. If this is horizontal and air is blowing like this, the value will be different because the laminar and turbulent region may occur. I don't know what will happen. If it is horizontal, if I keep like this and air is flowing perpendicular to this direction, then what will happen? Heat transfer rate will be varying. You check out how much it is going to vary and what is the procedure to be followed. So here what he is asking extra, which is not covered till now, is just I will give a hint how to solve. You try to solve. This is not an assignment question. You try to solve for better understanding. So this is case one. And this is case two. L is this. L here it is 50 centimeter. Here it is 25 centimeter. Case two. Okay, case one and case two. Here, the flow region may occur like this. Here, very small distance. Because of this small distance, we'll have all the values different. So first you, in both the cases, you find out this TF. Then after TF, properties. See, there is no change. TF in both the cases will be different. Same, properties also will be same. So after this, we'll change everything. Find out Reynolds number here, Reynolds number here. Why? Because rho V L by mu, length is entire length. Here rho V L by mu, and length is 25, length is 50. Reynolds number will change. So I know, as per my knowledge, in both the cases, Reynolds number will be less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5. In both the cases, less than 10 to the power of 5. So the flow is, note, laminar flow in both the cases. But in some case, if it is more than 5, then you have to find out what Gautam said now. You have to find out laminar region, turbulent region, Q for laminar, Q for turbulent in this total Q. Then here also same way. Now in both the cases, luckily we have the laminar flow in both the cases. After that, find out Nusselt number. Hence it is laminar flow and the fluid is here. The formula remains same, but the values are different. Find out H average. Hence it is laminar and fluid is here, 2 into H. Find out Q. HA, T wall minus T surface. Same thing there also. T wall minus T infinity. Here also it is same. So now you found out two Qs. So what he is asking now? I know you can do this. So he is asking extra thing. I'll explain only that. Find out the effect of heat. Means you should write a note. Which is, what is the note you should write? If the plate is kept horizontal, means if the length of the plate is considered as 50 mm, what is the Q? If the length of the plate is 25, what is the Q? If I want to increase the rate of heat transfer, which is better? Like that, you should suggest. Then you write Q greater minus Q small. He is asking this. What is the difference in rate of heat transfer? Q greater minus Q small. Difference he is asking. Then he is asking percentage increase. This is one thing he is asking, which I have not done till now. Then percentage increases Q greater minus Q smaller. Hence he is asking percentage increase. It will become Q small. This is percentage increase in heat transfer due to change in orientation. That's all. That's how these two are the extra thing what he is asking in this problem. He is asking you to find out the difference in the Q. If it is parallel kept, length is 50, and if it is length 25, what is the difference? And percentage increase. I don't know which in parallel means in 50, if I take L50, whether the Q will be greater or lesser, I don't know. You have to check out that. So I written like this: greater minus smaller by smaller value into 100. You will get the percentage increase in the heat transfer due to the orientation change. Can you do this? Yes, can you do this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, this is not an assignment question. This is simply I am explaining the concept. These two are the different thing which is nature not covered. So I explain this. Next. One more problem is there. What is the problem? Almost same data, but instead of air, he has given sodium potassium as the fluid. Instead of air, he has given the sodium potassium as the fluid. Sodium potassium alloy flows with the velocity. Yeah, that is a fluid he has given. So you are supposed to take the properties of sodium potassium from the data book. That's all. Depending upon the fluids, you take the property. That is the change what we are expecting. Okay. So in the next class, few more problems I'll give you before coming for the next class. Please copy those questions that come. And now after this class. At sharp 1 o'clock, I'll post you the link of the quiz. I'll post you the link of the quiz based on heat transfer chapter, based on the chapter of heat transfer. So all of you be ready with the data handbook. Be ready with the
sir, heat transfer or lab experiment heat exchanger, sir.
I've used heat exchanger. The quiz on heat exchanger. I've used the quiz on heat exchanger. You know, theory part is also covered, no? Okay, I have concentrated more on the lab only, but few questions, one or two questions I have taken with the theory. Okay, no need to worry, you can answer that. If you are
attending questions,
10 questions, only 10 questions, I'll give 10 minutes of time. 10 questions, yes. 10 minutes. See, all of you be ready with the data handbook and Kelsey. Few questions I have given. Okay, you have to calculate and tell the answer. At sharp 1 o'clock, I'll post that, and 1:10, I'll wind up the quiz. The quiz title is Quiz on Heat Exchangers.
Sir, 10 okay. minutes, 10 questions with calculations, sir.
Yeah, you can do that. You can do. It is very, very simple calculations. Not complete
okay, sir.
Questions I have asked.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, if I give you 4 temperatures, if I ask you to find out LMTD, you can find out, no?
Yes, sir.
Like that. All those. And then open the data handbook. Data handbook is also important. Please be ready with the data handbook of heat exchanger. Calculator and a plane sheet. That is very important. 10 minutes, you have to complete the quiz. At sharp 1 o'clock, I'll post. 1:10, I'll wind up. Is it clear? Okay. Now, all of you, please type your revision number. You can leave the class. Thank you.